The UN Security Council is composed of 15 members, of which 5 members are permanent, including China, France, Russian Federation, the United Kingdom, and the United States, while 10 are non-permanent members elected for 2-year terms by the General Assembly. According to Tayewa, the absence of Africa on the panel of 5 has left the continent on the receiving end of world violence.
To assure our Chinese friends that Uganda will continue to fight for equal representation at the UN Security Council and will push for reforms to make sure Africa gets 2 permanent seats on the Security Council as per the consensus of the African Union.
The Deputy Speaker explained that Uganda and China have continued to enjoy, deepen and consolidate good relations in diverse fields, including cooperation in political, security, economic, social, cultural and scientific discipline. He sought China's support to Uganda's push for major reforms at the UN Security Council through China-Africa cooperation to cure historical injustices.
An efficient and effective United Nations that works for all the state parties with equal treatment, fairness and justice. Uganda is a member of the Committee of 10 on UN Security Council reform, which reflects Africa's legitimate right and aspiration to rectify the historical injustices endured by the continent.
While meeting with His Excellence Losang Jiangchun, the Deputy Chairman of the Standing Committee of the National People's Congress of the People's Republic of China, Tayewa also applauded the Chinese government for donating a fleet of 70 vehicles to Uganda to facilitate the hosting of the non-aligned movement and the G77 Summit Plus China slated to take place next year.
The summit now confirmed for January 2024. China has once again generously provided an additional 70 vehicles to support Uganda's successful hosting. We are very grateful for this support.
The engagement, which took place at the Parliamentary Conference Hall, was also attended by Uganda's Foreign Affairs Minister Henry Orem, the State Minister for Trade David Bahati, Government Chief Whip Dennis Hampson Obua, and the Shadow Attorney General Wilfred Niwagaba, among others. Tayewa expressed discomfort with the trade imbalance between the two states, with Uganda earning only $57.7 million, equivalent to 218.6 billion shillings in exports to China annually, compared to $880 million, equivalent to 3.3 trillion shillings in imports from China.
With trade relations, Uganda continues to export raw materials to China, which fetch low prices compared to the imports, which are high-value industrial products. The total earnings from Uganda's exports to China stand at US$57.7 million, compared to US$880 million imports from China.
Addressing MPs on through a translator, Mr. Losang commended the growing ties between Uganda and China, saying it's a key driver of development for the two partner states.
Cooperation between the legislative bodies of our two countries have been close. In 2013, China's National People's Congress and the Uganda Parliament signed a cooperation MOU, and we established friendship group respectively, and our mutual visit and exchanges at all levels have been frequent, playing an important role in promoting our traditional friendship. I hope to establish and maintain a good working relationship with Your Excellency, continue to promote the development of China-Uganda relations and strengthen the exchanges and cooperation between the two legislatures.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.